Hey there, Mercedes here from Prettywebz.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own custom watercolor brushes inside of Photoshop. And later in the video, I'll show you how to get this free download, so stick around for that. If you like this video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to this channel, and visit Prettywebz.com for more design resources for your blog and business. Now let's get started. So we're gonna start creating this custom brush with a texture. So we're gonna go ahead and create that texture first, and then we'll get started on the brush. And this is gonna be really quick. Make sure that you have your foreground and background color set to black and white. You can click these two little default, that little icon for the default right there. And then come up to filter, render, and then clouds. So all we want is just this cloud look. And you can bring up the levels for that if you want it to have a lighter color to it. So I don't really want a lot of contrast here. So I'm gonna bring that up a little bit. Click OK. Now I'm gonna create a texture out of this. So I'm gonna click Edit up here at the top menu and then go to Define Pattern. And I'm gonna call this my watercolor. Okay, on this layer, we're going to create our brush. We're going to be working in the legacy brushes. If you don't see this, it should be default with Photoshop, but if you don't see it, you can come to the little hamburger menu, the little drop down, and click on legacy brushes, and then those will load up for you. I'm going to be using just the default brushes inside of legacy brushes. And I'm coming down here to this oil heavy flow, and I'm going to choose that brush. So all I'm doing, I'm going to bring up that brush quite a bit, and I'm painting with black, and I'm just going to make kind of like a circular shape. It doesn't really matter. All I'm really looking for are these edges right here. So I like the rough edges that this brush has. But I'm just gonna make some edges. I'm just getting that exterior texture for my brush. And I'm happy with this. So, and yours doesn't have to look exactly like mine. All we're looking for is a good edge for our brush. You don't want it to be too smooth. We want it to bleed out a little bit. Once we have that created, we can go to Edit. Define brush preset, and we're gonna define this brush as watercolor base. Click OK. And now we've got our brush. I can turn that layer off, and I'm gonna add a new layer. And this layer we're just gonna use to test our brush with. I'm gonna decrease the brush size. And then I'm gonna come over to the brush settings here on the side panel. If you don't see it, you can come up to Window and then Brush Settings, and it'll open up for you there. Make this smaller. Okay, I'm gonna choose this very top section right here, Brush Tip Shape, and I'm just gonna take my spacing down to 1% and my brush size, I'll leave it at about 175. Okay, now we'll come into Shape Dynamics, and I'm gonna set my size jitter all the way up to 100%. Make sure that your control is pin pressure. Even if you don't have a tablet, it's gonna make a big difference in the flow of the brush. So make sure that that's on pin pressure, your angle at about 25% or so. We'll turn on pen pressure here as well. And everything else is fine. Then we'll come over to texture, and we're gonna add that texture in that we just created, the clouds. So we'll add that in, and we're going to scale that to 100% is actually good. So we'll leave that at 100, brightness 0, contrast is at 12 is fine. Make sure that texture each tip is ticked off. We don't want that on. And your mode is set to subtract. Your depth will bring down to about 75%. And again, we can work with this and see what we get. But right now you have something that looks like this. It's not exactly what we want, but we're getting there. So We've got that, and then we're gonna come into dual brush and we're gonna add another brush texture here. And we're gonna use this soft round brush right here. It's a soft round 30, but we're actually gonna bring the size up to about 100. Spacing we'll bring down about 5%. And then we're gonna do scatter both axes. And we'll bring that up to about 400%. And then our count will be 8. So we want a lot of that. So we've got something that looks more like this now. We just have a few more settings that we're going to add here. We're going to add transfer. And our opacity is going to come up to about 30%. Pen pressure. Okay, and then we want to add wet edges. We need buildup and then make sure that smoothing is set. Okay, and that's it. We've got our first watercolor brush. And you can see how this flows together really nicely there. So once you're happy with the way your brush looks, you can come up to the hamburger menu again. And in the flyout menu, choose new brush preset. And by the way, I do have a video that will show you how to save, export, import, and do all of that stuff with brushes. So make sure to look out for that if you want a more in-depth tutorial about saving and exporting brushes. So I'm going to call this brush watercolor 1. And now I have my watercolor base and my watercolor 1 here. I keep the watercolor base in case I want to make changes or if I want to scrap everything I have here and then just make a whole new brush, I can do that. But now I'm going to come in here to this brush and actually make another brush out of this one. So let me actually make this default, make sure that I'm on my black brush. You can kind of keep going with it until you find something that will work. I think I'll stick with this right here. And I'm just going to make a brush setting out of this. So I'm going to define brush preset and I'm going to call that base 2. And with base 2 set, I'm going to come back into the brush settings and do pretty much all the same settings. And now we've created a whole new brush. From that second brush, I'm going to go ahead and change the color again back to that pink color. And you can see that this one's much lighter and it bleeds out really nicely. I'm going to go ahead and save this one as well. So I'm going to go to new brush and I'm going to call this watercolor 2. And if you want to pick up the two brushes that we created here in this video and a few other bonus brushes as well, you can go over to prettywebz.com. I'll leave the link right here on the screen. So that was how to create watercolor brushes in Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed this video. Get more step-by-step tutorials by clicking on one of the videos on the screen right now. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching.